Hey, what's up, guys? This is Ricky on a very special episode of Two Bit da Vinci, coming to you from our backyard because we're doing a little bit of outside camping with my son and my team, and we're going to talk about this, the EcoFlow Delta Pro. For the past 10 years, I've had solar panels, and for the past 3 years, I've had a Tesla Powerwall. So as a result, my entire electric usage, my entire house, air conditioning, everything else, and about 18,000 miles a year on my EV, charging it at home, cost me $600, which is amazing because before that, when I had a gas car, I'd spend $1,500 just for gasoline, forget the house. But then I've moved and now I live here, and my current house, which is awesome and we love it, it was our dream house, but it neither has solar panels or a battery. So as a result, our electric bills are outrageous right now. And living in California and especially in San Diego, our prices are through the roof. So for December and for November of last year, we paid over $800 in electricity and another $600 for natural gas, which is bonkers. But we're not gonna be ready for solar or a battery just yet. And the reason why is because we're thinking about doing an integrated solar roof. This roof that we have now needs to be replaced. We couldn't just put traditional panels on it. And secondly, for the battery, I'm still thinking about what kind of a system I wanna use. That's why I reached out to EcoFlow, and huge shout out for sponsoring this video. EcoFlow sent me this. This is the EcoFlow Delta Pro, and I freaking love this thing. So full disclosure, EcoFlow did mail me these batteries, but our opinions are our own, and we've been using this for over 4 months and love it. First of all, if you wanna have fun, if you're outdoorsy, you do things like camping, or you have an RV, this is absolutely fantastic. This unit right here is the main system, and it has 3.6 kilowatt hours of energy storage. But if you need more, well, then you've got this. This is the add-on system. This doesn't have any of the controls or any of the interfaces. It just connects. Let me show you how it connects in the back. Here on the back, these are your add-on ports. So each one of these batteries can add up to two other batteries. So for a total of about 10 kilowatt hours. But hooking it up is as simple as plugging in that cable. Get a little bit closer here and plugging in this one. They actually swivel to make it easy to line up. And so now these two batteries are hooked up together, and all the controls and all the brains are still here, but I've got double the capacity. So before we jump into all the specs and features and all that kind of stuff, I want to show you a couple of the fun ways that we use this thing. Let there be light. Ooh, that's bright. Right now we're pulling 140 watts, which is the light TV and gaming computer. We'll see how high that goes. Right now it's saying 17 hours, which will power us through the night. And because it has a solar charging element, we could potentially charge it all back the next day and just live on this thing. Maybe not an entire house, but you could live in a tent with a gaming computer and everything else. And the total output is 300 watts. And at this rate, I could go 18 hours. Now, it is gonna be cold, probably. It's January, yeah, it's San Diego, but it does get a little bit chilly at night. So I might run a radiant heater, like a space heater as well, which will eat into that range, but we'll see. So my real question is, how many hours of gameplay can we get on this thing before the battery gets run down? That's kind of the question that we're here to answer.
It's one of them.
Yes, there's other stuff, non-gaming stuff to talk about as well. We were playing a game that was medium intensive, and it didn't really do all that much to the energy usage for the unit, but now we have Cyberpunk 2077, which is a controversial game. Let's not get into that, but there's a little quick little look at it. Okay, so now here's what's gonna happen. Right now we're on the menus, so the card's not really working very hard, and we're at 360 watts, right? So go ahead and resume playing. Okay, so now he's playing, okay? And now that he's playing, it has jumped up to 700. And our 15, 16 hours of battery life has plummeted to only 7 hours. The purpose of this video is to tell you about how we use this thing. Juan's right, this isn't just about having picnics and video game sessions in the backyard. This is our only form of battery backup. So that means if the power were to go out, these massive units are the only things that we have that could store energy. So in a pinch, if I needed to, I could run my refrigerators and the really critical things by just plugging into these front ports here right on front. We also have electric bicycles and one wheels. And so this becomes our weekend warrior battery, which we just throw in the trunk and we use whenever we need to charge stuff on the go. So those one wheels have about 20 miles of range, but with one of these, you can charge three or four of them all back together while we take little breaks for lunch and things like that. So that takes us really quickly to flaw number one. This is a 3.6 kilowatt hour battery pack, and it's actually fairly compact for that much energy storage, but this thing is really heavy, about 100 pounds. So moving it around isn't exactly easy, but for me, I can move it around decently by myself, but it does have really awesome build quality. It's very manageable to move around. It feels like it's not gonna go anywhere. And with this airline style luggage holder, once you've got it down on the ground, you're just rolling it around. So, you know, moving it like this is not so bad, but loading it into and out of a trunk, that might be tough. So get an extra pair of hands. Don't hurt yourself for sure. But this is a heavy battery. So as much fun as this is for camping and RVing and all your outdoor activities and stuff, it's actually really practical and pragmatic as well. This is actually not just a battery, it's also a solar charge controller. This is the port that you would plug in for solar. You can actually charge it from your car cigarette lighter as well. But plug into that and you're not just storing energy, but you can charge it from the sun. So after camping in our backyard, we used about 4 of the total of 7 kilowatt hours overnight. So that was 4 hours of gaming with the TV on and the speakers and everything else and the gaming computer. And also for heating that tent, because it is winter here in San Diego, it's about 45 degrees at night, keeping that tent warm with a space heater. So even with that heater running all night and staying comfortable, we used 4 kilowatt hours and we had 44% left. So now you're thinking, what happens the next day when you want to use it again? Well, you could just plug it into AC and charge it, and it charges really fast over the wall. But you could also charge it over solar, and this is what I want to show you right now. So EcoFlow actually sells a incredibly cool and compact fold-out solar panel, and this is their biggest of their offerings. They have various sizes, but this is the 400-watt one. And look at how dirty it's already gotten in just a couple of weeks. But this here can produce 400 watts. Now, not right now because the sun is pretty low in the sky. It is January, but in peak ideal angle conditions and everything else. And it's also a really cloudy day today. So this here connects to a cable on the system and charges the battery back up. Now, with this, I was getting between 200 and 300 watts, which means it would take 10, 20 hours of solar to charge your battery back up, which in the winter, maybe 3 days. But here's what's really cool. My old house, I had these extra 4 solar panels that I didn't end up using. There just wasn't enough roof space for me. So they were sitting around collecting dust, and I thought, well, what if I wire them in? So these panels are about 50 volts each, so I couldn't wire them all together because that would overload the voltage limit. So what I did is I put those two in parallel, then I put those two in parallel, so that's 50 and 50, 100, and then this is about 30 volts or so, and put that, so there's 3 sets of items in series. As a result, the total voltage is about 135 volts, well within the limit, and I can charge the battery in about 1 day like this. So even though it comes with this foldable pack, what I normally will do is keep this folded away for travel. Like if you go somewhere, you're RVing, you're camping, keep that handy. You can pull it out on top of your car, your RV, on the grass around you, and charge the battery back up. And this is more of a permanent fixture. And let me show you what I do with this thing. Because I'm off-grid, this battery is not feeding my house yet because I don't have a net energy metering plan with my utility company. So I can't feed power back. I can't make solar energy just yet. What I have been doing with this is charging my Tesla because my Tesla is just a big battery out in the front of my house. So the EcoFlow charges over solar and charges the battery. And then the battery has an inverter that can then output electricity and charge my car. So that's what this cable is here. So here's how I have it all wired up. I've got these series connectors. This isn't that important. And be sure to read the specs and everything else. This is all very temporary. I was just kind of doing a science experiment for the purpose of this video. But when it all wires up, feeds into these final 2 cables, which is running into the house, into the EcoFlow. And then from the EcoFlow, I have this single, really long extension cord that runs along the perimeter of my house to the front, where I can plug in my Tesla. Okay, so then I've got the extension cord coming in here, just plug it into the front of the battery. And now this is just a story about my favorite tech of the year, this battery. If you have any questions about electricity or anything else, look around, there's some great YouTube channels, but this is a bonding cable that you need in order to charge your Tesla. So with my gain of 44% or so from my solar panels, I'm gonna show you how I charge my Tesla. So I am literally driving on sunshine.
I don't have the AC circuit turned on just yet, but here is the cable and here's the AC adapter. I'll plug it in. Here's my charging cable. So we're gonna plug it in. Nothing yet because the AC unit is not on. But now that everything is hooked up and good, I'll go to the EcoFlow. Okay. Now it is running and I think it's charging. It is. It's pulling 1300 watts right now. So a couple of things real quick I wanna talk about. This is not permanent. This is kind of a stopgap measure until I get my solar installed. That extension cord is rated for about 2000 watts, but just to be safe, because it is a 100-foot cable, I have the car charge at a very low rate to keep it not even close to that. It doesn't matter because if I'm getting about 20 miles of range from solar, then I don't need to charge all that much. So how much performance do I actually get? Well, I did the math on this over the course of a couple of months. With the fold-out 400-watt panel that the EcoFlow comes with, the one that provided by EcoFlow, I can charge about 8 miles a day. So that means if I just drop my son off at school and pick him up around 8 miles a day, I could keep my car charged and never have to need any more than that. Or if I need more than that, I bought these panels used, by the way. I got them for about $75 a panel and I got four of them. You can do the math, pretty economic if you find them used. And with all those panels, I can drive 18 miles a day, and that's in the winter time. That's with shorter days, less direct sunlight. So in the summertime, that would about double to about 36 miles a day.
So if you don't have solar or you don't plan on getting the solar panel edition that they sell, how would you charge this thing up? Well, you charge it over AC, just plug it into the wall. And what's interesting is this port is actually 100 to 240 volt AC, which means if you have a 240 volt port, you can charge it at 15 amps. You can charge this thing at about 3,600 watts, which is really quick. It'll charge it up in like under 2 hours. Otherwise, a traditional wall circuit will charge this in these two batteries together in about 5 hours, or just this one possibly in about 2 hours. Interestingly, this battery also comes with a charge cable. They call this their infinity port here on this side of the battery. But this actually is what you would plug into like a level 2 fast charger on the road. So if you're on a road trip, even without an EV, you just pull up your car, pull this out, and you can plug this in and charge from an EV charging port on the road. Now, in terms of what kind of stuff you can power, you have direct current right up in front, which means it goes right from the battery as DC right out to your appliances. So if you have laptops that are USB-C, iPhones or smartphones, other things, iPads, things like that, you can plug in right up in here. Now for the AC, you have four 20 amp circuits up here for the AC. And then you even have a 240 volt port over here. This could power something like an electric dryer, for example. And that gets to one of the really amazing parts about this battery, which is it has a 3600 watt output capacity. That is enough to power everything in my house except for the air conditioner. The air conditioner and blower for my house is about 5,000 watts. So I couldn't run that, but I haven't really found anything else that I couldn't run off this battery. As I mentioned, I don't have solar, which means I don't have a net energy metering agreement, which means I can't sell energy back to the grid. So for example, I do most of my work out of our in-law suite, and in that room, all the computers and everything that I use is plugged into this battery and charges over the sunshine. So that one room in my house doesn't contribute to our energy usage. The rest of the house does, but the cool thing is with two of these batteries, you could actually run your entire house. So this is the main unit, right, the Delta Pro. With two of these, they actually have a smart home panel you can have installed by an electrician, and then these could power your house. They become like a power wall. So how much does it cost? Well, this is a 3.6 kilowatt hour battery pack, which is about 26% of a power wall's capacity. And the price is also about 26%. So on a per kilowatt hour basis, it's very comparable to a Powerwall. But remember, this has a solar charge controller and other functionality that other batteries just don't have. So if you get two of these, I could actually power my house. And then remember that each one of these can plug into two of those, which means that up to 25 kilowatt hours of storage is possible. And because they're modular, meaning you can just buy this one today and then buy another one later, you could potentially just buy this one battery for now and then in the future upgrade and add on to it. Am I gonna use this for my whole house battery? I'm not sure. I'm still kind of deciding how I'm gonna do this. But for me, because of the packaging and the handles and everything, I don't think so. I think I'm gonna keep this for adventures. Whenever we go anywhere for weekends, when we go camping, I wanna buy an RV. My wife, I don't know if she agrees with me on that one, but if we do anything like that, this is what I would grab. Because yeah, it's 100 pounds, but it's so all well built in, and it's just a complete package and it's ready to go. The second drawback, there's only two drawbacks I could find with this battery. The second is that it's a little bit loud. You'll see there's fan ports right up in here. And this battery has really great thermal management systems. So the battery, as it's discharging, if it warms up to any kind of a temperature, the fans kick on. So this is going to last you a really long time. This is a lithium iron phosphate chemistry, which EcoFlow says is good for about 6,500 charge cycles. I believe that because that's exactly right on track with what all lithium iron phosphate batteries are. If you charge it and discharge it every day, that's over 18 years, by the way. 700 watts, and here's what it sounds like on medium. And now just for fun, here's high. I'll plug in this space heater and I'll turn that on. So this is the fan on high right next to it. So the way to get around that is keep this battery a little bit further away from you, right? You run an extension cord, keep this further away in an adjacent room or in a closet, something like that, something ventilated. And that's not really much of a problem. It's heavy and it is a little bit loud when the fans kick on. Those are the two cons. Otherwise, you would be amazed at how much of your house you could run with one of these. This is an amazing battery for battery backup and being emergency prepared. My mom and dad live on a house where they have well water, which means when the power goes out, their water goes out. With one of these, he could roll it into a shed, unplug it from where it goes into, plug it into this, and he could have water in the event of an emergency. And when he was done with that, he can unplug it and move it, right? That's the beauty of this thing. Interestingly, here's one other thing. If you have time of use metering, which means you pay different prices depending on the time of the day, well, one of these, you could have this charge up between midnight and 6 a.m. So for us here in San Diego, midnight to 6 a.m., super off peak, costs us about 11 cents per kilowatt hour. So we could charge this battery in that time to full. For 7 kilowatt hours worth of energy, maybe I could run like a window AC in the room I'm working in, all from this, and keep that energy off my bill without any agreements, without having to agree to anybody or anything else. That is a look at the EcoFlow Delta Pro. I have yet to see a battery in this form factor with this much storage, with this much expandability and capability before. And I think if you're in the market, definitely go check out the other reviews. I've seen some pretty amazing reviews on this thing. I was watching YouTube videos for a couple of days, kind of preparing to understand how this thing works. And I'm not alone when I say this thing is super awesome. So what do you guys think? Are you in the market for a battery? Are you thinking about going solar or anything else? Are you kind of the tinkerer who'd love to mess with solar panels without actually having to get an agreement with a utility company? Or what is it about EcoFlow you have questions about? I can definitely try to reach out to them and see if we can get answers and stuff. Thanks so much for watching, everybody. We really appreciate you guys. If you have any questions, let us know. Just sign up in the comment section. We look forward to it. And check out some of our other videos we think you're going to like. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Ricky, and this is Two Bit da Vinci.